to our professional trainer category. And I'm pleased to announce the inductee of the professional trainer category is Mr. Peter Fury.
It's Chris for BBTV and we're in London, Heathrow, the Thistle Hotel, Heathrow Airport. Yeah. It's a lovely evening. We've had a great day, Peter, as well. We've been over here. It's the Xboxers Hall of Fame and you've been inducted today into the Hall of Fame for your services to boxing training. You got up there, received the award. It's been a great day all round, hasn't it, for everybody? Congratulations, certainly in order as well.
I think so. I was only saying to Billy Nelson, you know, what a surprise that me and him ended up here on the same day. It was very nice. Nice to be, here with some legendary people as well. It was such a big event. It's massive. Full credit to him for putting it on. And all the people that nominated me to be here, so fantastic. It's very much appreciated.
We've got some real legends in the game here as well. John Conte was here, Duke McKenzie, we've had Johnny Nelson, Billy Schwer. I mean, the list goes on and on. There's been some good names here.
George Groves was here as well. Some good fighters here.
Yeah, some good old timers here as well,
I enjoyed it when the old timers got up and they started speaking. Not much older than myself, really. But I enjoyed it. It's nice to hear. It's nice to hear the history. It was nice.
Like I said, some are getting up there, 60 years in the game, and we were saying some of these amateur coaches have been awarded as well for stuff they do in the game, which sometimes gets unnoticed as well. So, it's nice all around for everyone to get a bit of credit in the game.
I think the amateur coaches need massive accolades, and it was nice for Billy Schwer's dad, wasn't it? That was a touching thing that was very nice to listen to. You know what? He is right. These young kids have got to start somewhere, and they come through. These amateur trainers, that there is, and I know a lot of amateur trainers as well, especially at the Bowery. The thing is, they don't get enough credit because they're not seen enough. It's like, if you're not seen, people don't know who you are, XYZ. Remember, 99.9% of good fighters come through the amateur ranks. So without amateur boxing, nobody would be here. They're the foundations. I will say this, they're the footings of your lovely house. They are, because they're the ones that build the foundation. So amateur boxing is my credit, especially to this. So it's a very good thing, because all people like this are getting the accolades they deserve.
Because it's proper people behind it as well, boxing people behind it, who know the game inside out.
That was a good thing, because they're all your own kind of people here that understand boxing inside out. Especially, like you said, the old boys going back, and the respect that's shown in there is on another level. It's my kind of thing, this, because everybody shows maximum respect. You can't buy respect, can you?
Absolutely. And a nice framed certificate there, and a nice ornament to go pride of place in the gym, I suppose, or on the mantelpiece as well.
It's all about, like I said on up there, without the fighters, I wouldn't be here. It's all a team effort, whatever you're doing, but it's not easy. To be at top level with anything, it takes a lot of sheer hard work, down times, up times, round and round and round. Not easy, but it's a great sport, and that's why we're here.
It's been a good day. Peter, you is with us today on the table. He's been there and he presented you with the award as well. He's got a fight coming up soon this week. You've had this with Savannah Marshall as well. The fight was postponed. He gives an update on that as well. But first, Yui, his fight's actually before Savannah's now, isn't it? It's October.
Oh, lucky, yes.
He gave me the wrong date. But yeah, you've got plenty going on. Savannah's fight was cancelled recently. And it's been rescheduled. There must have been so much thought and to gone into that about what he was going to do with it, but in the end, they decided to pull the show. And there was a lot of collateral damage there with you know, stuff that comes off it, but he felt it was the right thing to do, and it's back on again for a new day.
Well, you know, we all had a chat, the team, and, you know, spoke to Sky, you know, Adam Smith, Ben Shalom, you know, John Lushusen, we all spoke about it, and, you know, they said, you know, it does need to go off. It wasn't my decision, you know, but they conferred with us with it. And look, we've only got one queen, and she's passed away. Life to me is worth more than any event anyway. So to show the respect for the queen is a massive thing. So I got no problem at all. So basically, it is what it is. But look, it's happened. It's beyond anybody's control. It wasn't ideal. But the queen's passed away, so I understand it. I must give maximum respect what is due. And she was a great woman for the country, a great person, and a believer in the blessed Lord. So, you know, she was a faultless woman, so she needs all the respect. As far as the fight goes, 15th of October. So I said to Savannah, you know, you've got to class this like you've had the fight. Because you've got a hard camp, there's a lot of emotions running and everything else. So she's had the week off. I've not seen her since that day, since it was called off. And she's back in the gym on Tuesday. But obviously, it's a funeral tomorrow. And we're back in the gym on Tuesday and back to work.
How did Savannah take the whole sort of, you know, knowing that it was going to get called off? How did she get her head round? And not obviously the circumstances, but knowing where she was fitness-wise, her head was all prepared for that night. And how do you bring her back down and get her back up again, if you like?
Well, the good thing with Savannah, it's happened to her before. She's not new to this, you know. I got COVID, and the last one was off. That got put back 2 weeks. This has been put back 4 weeks or whatever. So she's used to it, and in boxing, she knows now, you know, you can expect the unexpected. So it's not really, obviously, the work that goes in and everything else, it's on another level, especially that level. You know, it's happened, so she's a realist. She didn't say a lot, she just said, okay, let me know when I'm back in the gym, and we'll get to work. So she's a professional, and she knows it's just a blip. So, no problem.
And as a trainer, you know, like you're getting to peak for that night, do you just, how do you, you know, sort the training out now and knowing that she's ready again and hitting that same peak in another 4 weeks, you know?
Because, you know, you've got to know what you're doing, you know, so that's why she's had 8 or 9 days off, yeah. Probably 10 days before she's back in the gym, and she'll start having an easy week back in, and it'll start building up, and then she'll come down again, and she's ready. But I won't be killing Savannah in the gym, because she's already there. All I need to do is pick her up at a certain level, keep her there, drop her back down, away we go again. All the hard work's done. It's still in her tank. You know, what do I need to kill it for? She ain't gonna lose all that fitness in 10 days. So basically, leads back into it. Because, you know, we've got our own methods, and my methods has worked up to now, so I'm happy with it.
They're both in the same boat as well, aren't they? Both girls are in the same boat.
They're in the same boat, yeah, and, you know, massive respect to all of them. Yeah. You know, so both of them, so I'm looking forward to a good fight.
Yeah, looking forward to that, definitely. And Yui's with us tonight there. He's looking really well as well. He's not far off this rescheduled fight with Michael Hunter as well, so... end of October, that's all systems go out. How's all that going now? It's all back on, and Yui's looking good.
Yeah, it's all back.
Over all the illnesses and everything.
Exactly, so we're getting on with that, and yeah, so far so good. Everyone's have to take every day as a call, but my main focus right now is getting Savannah over the line.
Yeah, then concentrate on Yui.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, Peter, we're, the event's finished now, so we're going to get off, but I'll catch up with you before you went and update on things. But
pleasure to have you with us, Chris, and I'm glad you've enjoyed it.
Yeah, yeah, Peter, it's an absolute honour to come over there and be with you this evening. Thanks for inviting us over and having us on your table.
Well, we go back a long way, so it's nice to have you. It really is, and actually as well. I'm glad you've enjoyed it.
God bless you. Thank you.
You,
and a safe trip home, and we'll catch up soon, hopefully before the fight. I'll come up to the gym.
Looking very smart as well.
Thank you, sir. You're not too bad yourself.